Tony Hayward's relentless drive for short-term profit led to cutting corners and ultimately death and destruction. It is a demonstration of greed and selfishness, not leadership.
It's absolutely disgusting that the university thinks it's appropriate to invite Tony Hayward here on like the 10th anniversary of the Iraq War, when he's been so implicated in actually like increasing tensions in that area.
An oil price floor of around about $100 a barrel, and we could see prices go above that, and with further political unrest somewhere in the world, we could see prices go a lot above that.
Finally, of course, we have the Deepwater Horizon catastrophe, and the more evidence that comes in, the more it's clear that that event was foreseeable and it was avoidable.
We're sorry for the massive disruption it's caused to their lives. And, you know, there's no one who wants this thing over more than I do. You know, I'd like my life back.
He did destroy quite a lot of fisher people's lives, and I think there's probably quite a lot of people who want their lives back since the Gulf of Mexico oil spill.
For the benefit of all Iraqis, and for the benefit of Kurdistan, and for the benefit of the contractors that are investing, clearly it would be much better if the oil was being exported.
Soaring food prices around the world are driving more people into poverty. The bank says its food price index is now 36% higher than a year ago. The prices of some staples like maize and wheat have risen 70% in the same period. The commodities giant Glencore has announced that it hopes to raise £45 billion through a partial flotation on the London and Hong Kong stock markets.
If the university is a global university, maybe it should be producing knowledge and information and research that is good for the globe.
So if you look at any of the sort of big issues that are affecting millions of people around the world, you take climate change, you take war, you take rising food prices, then Tony Hayward is sort of involved in all of them. He's exactly the opposite of the kind of person that the university needs to be holding up as a distinguished leader, and exactly the opposite of the kind of person we need to be making more of.